things always change in movie productions. Whether it's scenes, character or character designs.
The Transformers movies are no exception.
We had deleted scenes, removed characters, or character designs being replaced. For example, Hot Rod being replaced with Dino / Mirage in Dark of the Moon, Stinger being a female character in the early production of Age of Extinction, or the Megatron scene being removed from Bumblebee. Today I have a list of 10 things you may or may not know got changed or removed. Let's start with number 10. Jazz was planned in Bumblebee. In an interview with Travis Knight, the director of Bumblebee, he explained how much he wanted to include Jazz in the opening scene of Bumblebee, but sadly they didn't have the time. Time was short for them to make that scene. You may or may not know, but the Cybertron opening scene in Bumblebee was a last-minute idea to cut every connection to the Bayverse. So the opening scene was made in less than 5 months. Even some of the planned scenes was changed. According to John Bailey, the official voice actor of Soundwave as Shockwave, he explained that, for example, Ironhide had a scene where he was speaking, and Starscream was speaking in the opening scene as well. Travis Knight explained how much he wanted to include Jazz as it was one of his childhood favorite characters.
So if Travis Knight returns to direct the next movie, we're very likely going to see Jazz in it.
Number 9. The Last Knight had a very nasty scene between Izzy and Crosshairs. Nasty jokes are one of the things we expect from a Michael Bay movie. Sadly, the Transformers franchise was filled with these. One of the most disgusting ones was in The Last Knight. When The Last Knight ended early production, they released some B-rolls.
These videos showed the actors and crew while filming the movie. Some failed scenes, some jokes.
I remember seeing one that was very nasty in my opinion. Back then I even uploaded it to my channel as some of the deleted scenes from The Last Knight. This B-roll included Izzy, Isabella Monnier, and Crosshairs. The scene wasn't finished, so Crosshairs was only a pole with a tennis ball. It was a dirty and very inappropriate joke, at least in my opinion. Izzy was wearing some very questionable clothes, and I remember her character saying to Crosshairs to don't drop his jaw. I mean, that's disgusting in my opinion, she is a minor.
Sadly, making nasty jokes with minors are not first in the Transformers movies.
Statue 2705-3.
We all remember the scene. Number 8.
Crosshair's first design was based on Michael Bay. This comes from the very well-known artist Josh Nizzi, who have worked on almost all of the Transformers movies.
He posted a picture on Instagram when it was Michael Bay's birthday. You can clearly tell that the face was based on Michael Bay, and he even explained that in the description.
The first few designs he made was based on Michael Bay. For some time they went with that design. I even remember seeing one that had the iconic baseball cap that Michael Bay always wears. Later the design was changed and wasn't based on Michael Bay anymore. Number 7. Megatron was a dragon in Transformers The Last Knight.
When the first teaser came out for The Last Knight, it was simply a face of Megatron and some growling noises in the background.
We immediately thought that he is a dragon in The Last Knight.
I mean the sounds, the growling noises, the design, the tusks, the overall design was very beast-like.
And we all know that this wasn't the case. He ended up being a Cybertronian jet. Well, Josh Nizzi confirmed that Megatron was indeed a dragon in the early production of The Last Knight. He even posted some designs that he planned for Megatron.
In my opinion, this is way better than the Cybertronian jet. Why it was changed is unknown, but it is a wasted opportunity in my opinion. Number 6. KSI-2 had being a snake. This also comes from Josh Nizzi, who recently started posting never-before-seen concept arts, one of them being the KSI-2 head being very snake-like.
Sadly this was cut from the final version of the film, but if you ask me, this looks much more cooler than the final design.
Number 5. Overlord meant to be in Tier 5. Overlord is one of those fan-favorite Constructicon that we didn't see in the movie. His design was planned, but he never transformed, except for the combination for Devastator.
His design includes elements that are very beast-like, almost looks like a scorpion, and it looks awesome in my opinion.
Well, one of the writers from The Last Knight realized how much fans love Overlord, and he wanted to include it in The Last Knight.
He was planned to be this psychopath Decepticon, and was planned for multiple scenes. Josh Nizzi even posted some concept arts of him. He explained that later, Overlord was changed to Berserker. and his design ended up being a reused Dread model from Dark of the Moon.
Number 4.
Bumblebee almost had a mouth in TF5.
Josh Nizzi, as I mentioned, recently posted some never-before-seen concept arts of The Last Knight, Age of Extinction, Dark of the Moon, and so on. One of them being a scene concept from The Last Knight. The concept art included Bumblebee with multiple mouths. He explained that it was meant to be a funny scene where Bumblebee tried on multiple mouths to see which one works for him. Later, this was also cut and was changed to the Siri joke we all know.
Number 3. Galvatron meant to be a base former in Age of Extinction. This info comes from someone who worked on almost all of the Transformers movies.
He told this in a fan convention.
He explains that originally Galvatron meant to be a base former. You know, those Transformers that turns into bases and not into vehicles. He explained that KSI named their base Galvatron. And later this base transformed. I mean, it sounds like a lot of nonsense to me, so I'm glad it didn't make the final cut. Let me know what you think of this.
Number 2. Apps meant to be in TF4. This comes from the very same person who told this Galvatron base former story. He explained that Apps was meant to be in the opening scene of TF4 with Ratchet. Originally, the Autobot base was in the desert. This idea was most likely reused for The Last Knight, as the Autobot base was in Arizona.
Number 1. Hot Rod was almost green in TF5.
This is a very similar situation that almost happened to Drift in TF4.
Originally, Drift meant to be an orange and black Bugatti in TF4.
But when they finally agreed on the design, the car was sold.
So they had to get a different car, which was blue and black. This almost happened with Hot Rod in TF5.
Concept artist Josh Nizzi posted some concept arts of Hot Rod being a green Lamborghini. He explained that originally they wanted a lime green Lamborghini, but when the final robot design was finished, the car was sold.
So they went with a black and orange Lamborghini instead. I'm honestly glad that it wasn't a lime green Lamborghini, as it would have been a name slap in my opinion, which is very common in the Bayverse. So there we have it. These are the 10 changed things from the Transformers movies.
Let me know in the comment section below which one did you know and did not know before. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe if you are new. Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.